Welcome back to another Beeline to Passports. My name is Joe Batista. I'm your host, and I want to welcome everybody to our fifth season of the show. And like every show, we have a special guest, and tonight we have a beautiful person. Then she is an artist. She is a singer, also musician. She is a painter, and also she do makeup artist, full package. Tonight we have Miss Farah Elayuti. Farah, welcome to Beeline to Passports.
Oh, thank you so much. Really appreciate you. And thank you for having me today.
Thank you for accepting the invitation. And Farah, I want to know how everything started. I want to know where you from originally. How many people are in your family? How many kids? Your dad, mom, your education, all that good stuff that people want to know about our guest.
Okay, so first, my name is Farah Elayuti. I am Palestinian. This is my nationality. I was born in Saudi Arabia.
Okay.
And I was raised there, and I got married there too.
Right.
And I have three girls.
Wow.
Yes, I have three girls. And I have four sisters. I have three sisters and one brother.
Wow. And when you came to the U.S.?
So I came to the U.S. exactly 5 years ago.
Okay.
I moved from Saudi Arabia to the U.S., which was, it was a big transition for me, like to go from Saudi Arabia to the USA, you know?
Yes, so yes. Yeah, the culture is completely different.
Everything was different.
And I can imagine the food.
Of course.
And when you move here, you move to Central Florida direct, or you went to another area before you came to the Central Florida?
So I directly came to Central Florida.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because my husband relatives lives here, and he used to study here, so it's more familiar.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Basically, move over here. They have, you know, family members in the Central Florida area. Great thing, because it's not easy moving from another country and come to an area, then you don't know anybody.
Yeah.
And you start with the homesick, and you know, 90% of the people, I believe, is 90 or a little bit more, they live in the U.S. We are people that came from other countries. I'm original from Puerto Rico, born and raised in Puerto Rico, and moved over here 25 years ago.
Wow.
When I have the opportunity to work for Disney. That was my basically my door to come to the Central Florida area.
Wow.
And you know, after 3 months, you start getting the homesick.
I know.
You start missing your family. You start missing your friends, the food.
Yeah.
Because it's completely different. You know, it
tastes. Everything is different.
Unless you can put it on a plane direct from your home.
I wish.
they come straight to your doorsteps.
Yeah.
It's not the same.
It's not the same. And nothing is the same. Nothing is the same. Even the lifestyle.
Yes. Yes.
Lifestyle is totally different. Yeah, I struggled, to be honest, but I said, you know, you have to get yourself busy.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I studied. I graduated. I started working. I started to meet people. And what helped me more that I have already my social media is already established, but
okay.
I needed to gain more clients and followers in here.
Wow, wow. And what is your degree? Just say your story, but what is your degree?
It's a pharmacy technician diploma.
All right, yeah. Pharmacy technician. Okay, we need to add that too. You know, she is a pharmacy technician. She knows about legal drugs, people. And illegal too, because they yeah. need to understand
yeah.
both.
Yeah.
All right. You know, having education in that area, and basically your culture, you know, you bring your culture to the U.S., having that degree, working in that area, but at the same time, you start in the entertainment industry with, you know, acting, you like the music, you like to be involved on that area. Question, your family, anybody in your family, they're musicians, they are artists or entertainers?
No, it was only me. It was only me since I was a kid.
Okay, like, basically yeah. It's a gift. Wow. Wow. Love it. Love it. Love it. Because people don't understand, and even God give you that, you need to learn how to use it.
Exactly.
That is something that we talked in our show before. Be an artist, be a musician, actor is a gift.
It is a gift.
You yeah. basically polish, learning more, learning techniques, and put in practice every single time then they give you the opportunity exactly. to be part of a film or a band, you're a musician, or any other areas that your gift was provided. Because not only that, we were talking behind the scene here, she also loved to cook.
Yeah.
That's another gift.
Yeah.
They have people that don't know how to cook.
Oh no, I know.
they cannot boil water.
Oh.
Because they can create a disaster on a kitchen.
Maybe it's because of my culture. Mm-hmm. Basically, if you get married, you need to know how to cook. So
yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So in other cultures, it doesn't matter. They have McDonald's or any fast food, and then they can go yeah. and grab that or a pizza, you know. But it's great. It's great, you know, learning, you know, from your country, you move here, but you have that gift. And now you start developing and, you know, start showing more that gift that is besides. What is your career?
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing. Now, you mentioned you have three girls.
Yes, I have three girls.
The girls have mom's gift?
Yes.
The
oldest one?
Yes.
Her name is Sandra.
Okay.
And she has a very beautiful voice.
Nice.
And I have Lara. She's very responsible person. And the youngest, she can do sketches and painting.
Wow. Wow. Basically, you give the genes of the arts.
Yeah,
I know
that put the
part right there as well, but mom put the part of the gift
yeah.
or painting and doing other things. Then,
yeah.
it was a gift, definitely.
Yeah. Yeah,
awesome. Awesome. True. All right. Well, let's take this first commercial break. And when we come back from this first commercial break, we're going to continue talking about your career, what you have been doing in the last couple years, and also future projects and all that great stuff from Miss Farah Elayuti. We'll be right back with more of Farah Elayuti here in Belong to Passports on GKI Radio. Welcome back to this fifth season of Beeline to Passports. My name is Joe Batista. I'm your host. And tonight we have this beautiful guest. She is an artist. Why we call it an artist? Because I started calling her a full package. She can sing. She can play music. Also, she can act and she can paint. And also, she can do a beautiful makeup artist. And she do all this. All right, Farah. We talk about your career. Then you learn all this. And basically, it's a gift. But what project? Let's start with project like acting. We were talking behind the scene here. Then your first acting gig was recently. That was when we met.
Yes.
That was basically in January.
Yes.
How did people contact you? That I want to learn from that point. How do you receive the call? And then, hey, we're going to give you this opportunity to participate in this film.
So there's an app that I see some commercials. Yes. On wanted actresses or something for or modeling or something like that. So I saw that commercial about they need a Middle Eastern.
Okay.
And then the moment I saw Middle Eastern, oh,
yes,
that's my
yeah.
I gotta take it. So I just emailed them and they responded to me right away and they said, okay, we'll take you.
Yeah, you were cast because you fit on what they were looking.
Yeah.
Nice. And beside that one, any other project, then you have been called or then you are working right now, to do an acting part?
Okay. So for me as a content creator, it takes a lot of time of filming, editing, and I do it all by myself. So the ideas that I come up with, it's kind of like acting. If there's a video, there's a video that is showing, I was talking about Palestine.
Mm-hmm. You're good. Yes.
So part of the video I was showing a panic emotions, and then I was showing another emotion.
Okay.
So this is considered as acting.
Yes, it is.
Because you're going to be switching your emotion, your attitude. Sorry about that.
No problem. Yes, when you're in front of the camera, there can be a camera with your cell phone, because some people don't know today's cameras. In cell phones, they have the high quality that can be used for filming. I've been doing some films that has been done using cell phones.
Yeah, I believe that. Not only
big cameras, but for small independent projects, I've seen using the cell phones because they have the capability to do a film on 4K or higher quality with some sound equipment. Sometimes they use a lavalier, the microphone, the individual microphones, or a boom. Then people, they can capture all the area when the people are talking or the environment. But that's great. You're basically... you create your own content.
Exactly, yeah.
And you start doing, besides doing your own content, you start basically creating your own fan.
Yeah, that's true.
Wow.
And yeah, you can use the phone camera. I use my, there's, I have camera and I have my phone. So I use both.
Okay.
It depends on the scene or.
Nice, nice. Now, this is the part of acting. You add the music or singing also when you're doing the films? Have you you know, filming yourself singing?
I didn't. I feel like if you're providing content for art or makeup, it should be only for this.
Correct.
You know what I mean?
Individually, yes.
Yeah, but you were asking me if I filmed myself singing. Of course I did.
Okay, but it's not up in your...
It's not to upload on social media, okay. But very soon there will be content for singing because it's going to be a big event.
Oh, nice, nice. And we're going to talk about that very soon in here in our show. Now, we talk about painting and the makeup artist. And you do beautiful work.
Thank you.
You know, so pictures of your work. And it's incredible for a person that she mentioned, you know, gifted. The education, you know, was, and the person went to take painting classes, all that. No, she was gifted and self-taught.
Yeah, that's correct. That's wow. Totally correct. So the painting and sketching started since I was in first grade.
Wow.
They noticed, my family and my teachers noticed my gift, and the way I draw is different. They saw that in me. And as long as I got into my high school, my teacher used to give me the hardest paintings. Go do that. Go do it. So, yeah. So I'll say I got a lot of support from my family when I was at school from paintings. Okay, you want a guitar? We'll buy you a guitar.
Okay.
That was helpful. So helpful for me.
Wow. Well, basically, your family support you on all these basically challenges, having, okay, you want to paint? Okay, we're going to give you all the tools that you need to paint.
Exactly. And this is what helped me to keep going and keep growing that talent.
Correct. Correct. And that is something that I always said that is amazing when you have the support of your family, because everybody have a dream.
Of course, yeah.
Everybody want to become somebody.
That's
a song.
To be famous, to be seen, to be
correct,
heard.
Correct. And when you block or you basically put a barrier in between that dream and the child, that is bad.
That is bad.
Because you don't allow the person to be their self and to be somebody.
Exactly.
You basically cutting the wings of bird.
That's correct. And that's what I try to do with my kids, with my own kids. Try to tell them, like, if I see a talent in them, I would encourage them. Okay, go sing. Go on the stage. There's a talent show. Go participate.
Awesome.
So this is what I'm trying to do. But in my days, I used to go on the stage, sing in the contest and art contests.
Yes.
Too. So this is really important.
And that's amazing because you're creating, you know, with your kids, with your girls, you're creating a person, or you're helping to develop a person with a high self-esteem.
Exactly, yeah.
When you help them to achieve a goal. When we support that person on a goal, okay, that is helping the person for the future.
That's correct. And also, I would like to add just a small thing. So art or talents helps you during your hard times.
Yes.
Because you're not going to turn to bad stuff. You know what I mean?
That's correct.
So whenever you feel a negative emotions or something, I just go to my sketchbook.
Exactly.
Sketch it out.
Exactly. Exactly. And a musician, you know, I'm a musician and you understand that because, you know, I play percussion, you know, with the hand drums. When you play with a hand drum, you know,
exactly,
all this frustration that you can have,
exactly.
You know, hitting that percussion is something that, you know, help you to with any frustration. Mm. I remember in previous seasons, we have guests and they were young, they were doing bad things, you know.
Oh.
They were involved in gangs. Mm. They were involved in different areas. But when they found a call, being an actor, a singer, turns completely
everything.
Their life.
Yeah.
Because they start doing some stuff and basically separate themselves from that bad. They say bad area,
bad habits.
Definitely. Yeah. Wow. It's very interesting. And I applaud that you and your husband, they're doing, you know, this with the kids, because these kids, in the future, we will see them doing amazing things.
That's true.
Most definitely. But let's take another commercial break. And when we come back, we will continue talking about your career, all these great things that you want to achieve, projects that you have, and also your social media and the IMDb. But let's take this short commercial break. And people, we're going to this short commercial break, but remember to drop a comment or question if you would like to hear them answer on the show. The number is 407-476-9059. Remember to say my name, Joe Batista, followed by your name and your comment or question. And you could also hear it here in Beeline to Passports on GKI Radio. We are back from this short commercial break. Great music, and you're listening GKI Radio. My name is Joe Batista. I'm your host here on Beeline to Passports. And tonight we have a special guest, and this guest is, I call it, the total package. Her name is Miss Farah Elayuti. Farah.
Yes.
We talk about your career, what you have been doing, and also how you have been helping your kids developing their basically talents, because it's a talent, it's a gift. All right. Now, what projects you looking to achieve in this next year or so?
So I am looking to achieve to work with a celebrity.
Okay.
As a makeup artist.
Nice.
I want to have a collaborations with the big brands. This is my goals. And what I'm working on, I'm going to participate in Arab festival. I'm going to be singing. on a big stage.
Okay. Yes. Yes.
Which is exciting for me. And it has been so long since I did that. So this is what I'm looking forward to.
Nice. And that is coming up. You can say
May 14th.
Okay. May 14th, you are on stage. Yes. And it's going to be a public event?
It's public event.
Nice, nice. We're going to be in Central Florida?
I can give you the location. Give me just 1 second.
Sure, yeah. Sure. So, because we want to, the people, they listen in the show, they can go and see you in person and singing and cheer for you.
So the location is going to be in Dr. Phillips Center for the Performing Arts.
Basically in the downtown area. Yes. Dr. Phillips Performing Arts. Oh, yes. Wow. And they're going to be, you're going to be singing, you know, what kind of, or style, first of all.
Okay. So I sing all styles. Like I sing Arabic, I sing English. I'm going to perform almost 4 to 5 songs.
Okay.
On the stage.
Okay.
They're going to be different timing. I think one is going to be at 12 or 1 and the other one is going to be around 5.
Okay. And this kind of festival?
It is a festival. It is a festival.
And what is the name of the festival?
It's called Arab Festival Orlando. That's what it's called.
Okay. Yeah. Nice. Nice. Yeah. And you can go and see Miss Farah Elajuti. He, you know, doing her, one of her talents, singing. And you can see her beautiful face, you know, with all the makeup. And she do, you know, as a makeup artist. And hey, you can contact her through future plans or future projects that you have. Then she's open to assist and she's open to work on that projects.
Yes.
That's amazing. Now, other future plans that you have in, let's say, next year, something with acting that you said, hey, I'm looking to, just mentioned, you know, with a big performers or big names on the acting world, but locally, anything that you has been thought, okay, I would like to participate on this theater skit or in this event that I want to achieve.
For acting, I don't know my way, you know?
Yes.
So, like, I am interested to see how it goes, you know what I mean? And I'm interested to participate in movies because I like the ideas of the camera and the acting and everything, you know what I mean? So, for me, maybe because I cover my hair, I won't have a lot of opportunities. It was only that opportunity that I just took, that needed a Middle Eastern, but I wish I would have more opportunities to participate in movies or on theater because I feel like I have a lot of energy to give.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, no, definitely. And also, you know, it's basically being involved, networking, you know, go and participate on events. For example, with the Orlando Independent Filmmakers in the Orlando, now the OIF, I'm part of the OIF, Orlando Independent Filmmakers, and now we open the Tampa Independent Filmmakers. Oh. And we have challenges, at least 3 challenges per year, and that challenges are in different genre, horror, romance, comedy, okay. And you can participate in 3 movies, short films, in every single challenge.
Yeah, that's interesting. I would love to.
And yeah. And that helps also, you know, places like the UCF, The University of Central Florida. They have the Full Sail University, Valencia College. Mm. Then they have projects because, first of all, they have the film program on all three universities. And they basically, they make the students to do the projects. And what is the project? Mm. Do a short film. Depending what is your line of study, for example, you're a director in the taking the courses as a director, you need to have a writer, or you can write your own script and create this short film to present that as your final project before you graduate.
Oh, okay.
That is mandated. I've been working with several students as an actor and also as a assistant director in other areas.
Cool. Because I saw you that day.
they have many projects that they need to achieve before they finish their program and they graduate.
Okay.
Same thing with the Valencia College. Valencia College, the students, they need to do it. There is something that is mandated that they need to do. They have other areas depending where the people live in Florida. They have the Broward and Brevard and Melbourne that they have groups that they do films and they do film festivals. They have something that is called 48 hours. 48 hours is in a project, then they have 48 hours to complete a short film.
Wow.
That is a challenge.
That is a challenge.
You have 48 hours. That basically, people, 48 hours is 2 days. 2 days that you don't sleep.
Wow.
And when in basically the challenge is you need to present the script.
Oh.
The script is good. You have 48 hours to film, produce, first of all, produce, film, and edit, and present, show the film.
Wow.
48 hours.
Wow.
It's a challenge.
That's
people
a
does
lot.
It. People does it.
That's a lot. Yeah.
But if they have many, many, many projects, it's great. You know, you have, you know, your looks, and not only that, the desire that you want to participate, that you want to become a new face, let's say that way, a new face in the film industry.
Yes, yes, I am so.
That's awesome. That's awesome. But yeah, let's when we finish, we're going to talk about more of these projects. Then they're going to be around and you can be involved. But let's take another short commercial break. And thank you, people, for being with us in another Be Line to Passports, learning about Miss Farah Elajuti. A story, and we'll be right back with more of Be Line to Passports on GKI Radio. We are back. We are back from this short commercial break. Great music. You're listening to Be Line to Passports on GKI Radio. My name is Joe Batista. I'm your host. And tonight we have the beautiful Farah Elajuti. Farah, we talk about projects. We talk about, you know, all these great opportunities that you want to achieve, and that you're working on that goals in the next year, and so. Tell us your social media and your INDB that the people can start follow you and looking for your resume.
Okay, so for my social media, it's going to be under, the name is Fufita, Fofitta, makeup artist.
Okay, Fufita, makeup artist.
Yeah, that's going to be my Instagram.
That's on your Instagram. And what is your, you have an INDB? Not yet? Okay, we're going to work on that INDB. That's something that we're going to talk about right after the show. In the, also, you know, they, you need to start connecting other social medias, like the Facebook, you know, Meta, then is Instagram, WhatsApp, and that's also Facebook. And then people can start looking, you know, you can create your fan page and you connect one with another and all these things. But we're going to talk about that after the show. Now, looking more in the future, and you mentioned all these great things that you want to do, you know, singing, music, also as an artist. As a makeup artist, have you, you know, started looking on those some wrong ways than the people, you know, seeing your art, you know, as a makeup artist for the models, for the different fashion designers?
I might look for that. This is going to be my next goal. To look for that. The thing is, most of the fashion shows needs an artist, but outside of Orlando, it might be in Miami or Georgia, Atlanta. So, okay, it's nearby, but the thing is, I have a lot of commitments here.
Yes, yeah, your daughters, your pharmacy, your pharmacy technician.
Exactly. Yes. So, yeah, so this is the only thing that's keeping me away from doing this
stuff. But let me tell you, they do fashion shows in Orlando.
Yeah, whenever the opportunity comes.
They have some organization. They do fashion shows in the Orlando area. Perhaps they. I have a good friend of mine. Then she gonna do. This is gonna be the first. Kind of fashion show on the seas. Basically, they gone for 1 week on a cruise, and going on the cruise, they're gonna have a fashion show twice during 7 days.
Wow.
They're gonna have that. They're gonna be like a fun part, but at the same time learning, because they're gonna have some kind of training, education, but they're gonna have 2 days of runways.
Wow,
a fashion show.
Wow, that's cool.
And it's something different. Then she said last year, I'm going to change a little bit this, because I've been doing it in the Miami area, I've been doing it in the Orlando area, but I never, I want to do it on a boat.
Oh, no.
On a cruise.
Okay.
And she decided to this year do it, the fashion show on a cruise.
That's an amazing idea, though.
Yes, it is.
It's very nice.
Yes, it is. And most, because you can take the whole family for, you know, a seven-day cruise, and you're going to be there.
That's going to be cool. And I wouldn't say no.
and two days doing the runways and the fashion show. All right. Before we finish the show, your final thoughts?
Any final thoughts? I would say to anyone who has a dream, who has passion, always work on yourself, trust in yourself, believe in yourself. Do not listen to anyone else. If you love what you're doing, just do it. Do not wait for any other people validation. for you to do it. Just do it.
Yes. Yes. Definitely. That is great. That is a great final thought. And same thing, you know, and applaud you and your husband doing what you're doing with your kids.
Thank you.
Because that is something that every parent need to think about that. You know, if your kid have, you see they have a talent. It's not a forced talent. People don't understand what is a forced talent, then it's a natural talent or a gift.
Doing. Yeah, they love, like, if you see them, like, love what they're doing. Whenever they're free, they go, put on the speaker and start singing. That means they love what they're doing.
Correct. Correct.
Forced,
As a parent, we need to support that and look for, you know, that this kid get involved in a great and safe environment.
Exactly.
Then they learn more, they can become a great performers or a great artist. You never know.
That's true.
They said, and it's true, math helps with your life, but music help with math.
I know. Yeah, I understand,
yes.
But it's like kind of complicated to explain exactly
yes.
what it means. But that's true, because you're going to feel so good whenever you get that energy out.
Yes, yes, yes. And with the music and math, you know, you learn how to do certain things. And music is a universal language.
That's correct. Like, a lot of times you would hear a song, you don't understand the language, but you love it. You keep hearing that song, you keep playing that song, you don't understand the language, but you enjoy it. You find some kind of different emotions.
Correct.
While you're hearing that music.
Correct. And you feel better, and
yeah,
you get to the good mood.
Exactly.
That's
it always leaves an impression.
Yes. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Well, Farah, thank you for accepting the invitation. Thank you for giving us all this great information about you, about your career. And we want to see you shine and, continue with your career. And anything that we can do to assist you, let us know. And the doors of Beeline to Passports, same thing with Acelera Productions and Acelera Media Group. They're open for you to, be with us doing your projects.
Much. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
I had so much fun.
Thank you. And people, thank you for being with us in another Beeline to Passports. And remember, be a leader, rock the world, inspires others with your emotions in control. Good night.